Hello guys, I'm Content, this is Apricot5, and welcome to another edition of F1 2023 Career Mode. So, we're here in Austin, Texas for the United States Grand Prix, and I just got hit with huge penalties, grid-wise, and bad news is, I used up all my wear and tear of the engine, and therefore, I have to start way in the back, so my pole lap time is going to stand, but yeah, I get grid penalties, so 20 grid places behind, and I'll be starting dead last, 22nd, so basically, this is like everybody's dream, like, you want to start up front, but starting in the back is more of a challenge, so you need plenty of laps to, like, get up in the field and actually pass cars. And if you know Kyle Larson, he's the man that can do it. So, start from the back, come to the front, leading the race. So, and, yeah, the end of the race in the U.S. Grand Prix is interesting because I get the thumbnail title away and say, oh, who did I lose to? I lost to Lewis Hamilton, man. And it was interesting, you know, and as you've seen in my videos, he's been leading the points most of the way, and I snatched away from him, like in the middle of the season, so, yeah, and I was happy that our team kept winning and winning races, so we reel in Lewis Hamilton's point lead, and fortunately enough, this has happened, and yeah, the U.S. Grand Prix was a tale of two seasons. One, just not winning races, and two, we just ran strong and strong, and I mean, if you've watched most of my videos for the F1 23 playlist, you'll know that I try really hard to set a challenge for myself as far as AI difficulty is concerned, and like adjust it based on my skill level, and I think it's the right level. So I set it at 0%, I set it up to 40%, the 60%. So, and it wasn't an easy race to climb from the back of the pack. I had to draft route cars, like slingshot, and try to pass them to the left and the right side, and I mean, it was that race that, man, I didn't sleep on the competition, but everybody was asleep. Yeah, there was a few flashbacks back then, and I edited a few things so you didn't have to see me spin around and around and around, and yeah, fortunately enough, it's just a dream season, and basically I was just, man, on rails. Like, my upgrades weren't perfect, they weren't up to where I smoked everybody in one lap. It's just that we had a solid car, and yeah, I know this is a clip of Pirelli hot lap, but if you go further into the race, like last lap of the race, it was interesting. I was pushing hard and just, you know, it's like a racer's dream. Just always want to be first all the time, and it's not all about where you start, it's where you finish. And I believe 15 laps of trying to get to the front, it wasn't that easy. And in the Austin, Texas Coda track is really technical. Lots of loops to the left and loops to the right. I'm telling you, it's just wasn't easy, and you'll see in the beginning the middle in the other race. I show you my progression towards the front, and yeah, I smoked the slope, the back markers and the midfielders, and basically just did what I had to do, is just win the race or else. Or else you don't win the championship that way, you know, and it is what it is. So I'll end my commentating here. So for the 2024 year, give a thumbs up button if you like the video so much. Click on that bell button so you can subscribe from my YouTube channel, Happy Car 95, and get notifications in the future if you want to start watching my videos, or check the comments in the descriptions so you can share some thoughts and feelings with everybody in the community and make them feel welcome. So I'm at Happy Car 95. Hope you have a happy new year. Peace out.
Okay, we seem to be having a few software issues at the moment. Sit tight for a few minutes while we reboot some things, okay?
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Ali, Russell, and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race. Off the last few races of.
Right, mate, I know it's your home Grand Prix, but I want you to treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary risks, please. lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Thank you. Yes, nice work, mate. You did a really good job today. Pretty sure the boss is going to be happy with that one.
So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Ali increases their championship lead. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, goodbye. And with me today of
let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy. great pass. Okay, DRS is now available. Try to stay with them. They might make a mistake and we could still regain the position. Good job, nice overtake. race, final lap. We've only got 2 laps of fuel left. Yes, mate, I cannot complain about that one. That was an excellent drive. Well done.
That's it then for another magnificent United States Grand Prix. And they've hung on to take a sublime victory here today. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I want to know if that was as easy as it looked. An absolute masterclass today.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take the top spot. A well-earned victory for Mercedes. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the obvious choice at this point, but he's certainly a driver deserving of his great reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.
So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video right now, so give a thumbs up button if you like the video so much. Click on that bell button to subscribe for more content, and if you saw the recent video interesting, share the comment right below the description so you can share some thoughts and feelings with everybody in the community and make them feel welcome. So I make a happy Karlo 95. You'll have a great day and peace out.